good to go, so I'll kick this thing off. Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming. My name is Niran Babalola. I'm the founder of Panvala, and this talk is all about how you are going to collect stamps to change the world. So when it comes to changing the world in crypto, at conferences like this, like that's really what people are so excited about, the potential for this technology to change the world. But if you talk about this to like a normal person, it's really embarrassing to say that crypto will change the world. It's embarrassing to say because people have seen ape JPEGs sell for tons of money and they don't see how that's gonna change the world. If you say to somebody, oh, this is gonna change the world, they'll say, oh yeah, it's gonna change the world because it's gonna burn our environment by mining everything to death. Like, people have not seen a path to how this technology actually makes life better for anybody. But embarrassingly enough, it's still something I actually believe. And to understand why I believe that, I want to tell you a little bit about how I got into crypto in the first place. When I started in crypto, I actually thought Ethereum was a scam. There were these people who said that they were going to put a programming language in their money, and somehow that was going to make it worth more. It did not make any sense. It seemed like just one of those white papers that people put out there and try to get you to buy into their thing. So I ignored it. When I saw it again, it was actually when I started contributing to a project called Augur. I was really excited about prediction markets. If you haven't heard of what these things are, it's basically they let people bet on future events so you can get an accurate forecast of what's going to happen in the future. It seemed really cool to be able to build that in a decentralized way. I'm less excited about prediction markets now, but I was really excited about them. But it was really the act of contributing to this project that happened to be using Ethereum that made it clear what it means to have a programming language in your money, a programming language in your blockchain. It means that you can write down the rules for any interaction between individuals or groups of people, write down the rules like it's the rules of a board game. And instead of needing a game master to enforce the rules of your board game, you can publish these rules to a network of thousands of computers and they will enforce the rules for you. So literally anybody who believes there's a better way for people to work together and get things done in our world, if you think there's anything better than what's out there right now, if you figure out a better way, write down those rules, publish it to this network, you can do that forever. All you have to do is recruit the people to actually participate in that system with you. That is the opportunity that's out there. That's why, to me, this looks like a toolkit for social and economic organization, and that's why I believe that crypto will change the world. But when you say that it's going to change the world, people expect, oh, it's like nuclear power where the technology is going to do it for you, or like artificial intelligence where the technology is going to do stuff for you. Crypto is not going to do anything for you. You are the people that will change the world. It just helps you do it. It's the toolkit for organizing people that makes new things possible. You and organizing people together and things like DAOs, things like communities. When people talk about why communities are so important in crypto, it's literally because it does nothing by itself. It's all about moving people. And I think moving people is going to be the story of how this technology plays out. When it comes to all the problems we have in our world today, I'm sure you could list off a whole bunch of them. But when it comes to most people's ideas of how to solve them, there's really two main ways to do it. You can win an election, you can get like 51% of the people out there to agree with you on what needs to be done to solve the problem, and then just force everybody else to do it. Like, you got your politicians in power, problem solved. I'm sure they're gonna figure out a way to actually solve the problem they said they were going to. That's one way to solve a problem. It works a lot of the time, it doesn't work some of the time as well. Another way to solve a problem is to find a profitable way to solve it and build a company around it. So if the problem was people didn't have good enough phones in their pockets, you don't have to win an election to get that done. You just build a company, sell it to people, it's done. Those are the two ways that we solve most of the problems that we have. That's why our society is so dominated by either people saying, hey, we need to make as much profit as possible, or we need to get people to jump over to our political faction and everything's about political debates. These are the two ways we solve problems, and it kind of sucks. But there's a third way to solve problems, and it's literally by growing a community. It's the narrative that people are saying in crypto when they're like, oh, our community is so important, is literally, to me, a glimpse, a raw version of what it means to solve all the problems that are ahead of us without winning an election and without building a company. It's just by organizing a community that wants to get something done and doing it with them. coming together with the people we like to do the things we like is so important. It's where people are the happiest. They don't have to defeat their opponents. They just get to enjoy life with the people they want to cooperate with to get things done. What sucks, though, is that it's really hard to fund communities. It's hard to build a sustainable community that can financially thrive. So lots of people avoid it. They go to one of the other solutions. Maybe their community itself that started off as how can we voluntarily solve this problem turns into let's just win an election instead. We need to be able to solve problems in voluntary ways with the people who come together to do it on their own. But what we need to be able to do that financially is an endowment, something that we can draw from to be able to fund the things that we care about, the same way a university does or a very wealthy foundation does. We need an endowment to be able to fund anything any community wants to do. We need an endowment to be able to drive the solutions to our problems from primarily profit-seeking solutions or political solutions to voluntary communities with people who like each other doing the thing they like. That's the path to being happier together. What we believe in Panvala is that this endowment already exists. We already have an endowment that comes from you and I, and that you and I can control to take it to do whatever we want. The problem with that endowment is that it's being misappropriated. It's going into the wrong pockets. The endowment that we all share is literally the total spending in our advertising economy today. Every dollar spent to advertise is a dollar of value that literally comes from you. Facebook makes tons of money not because they've built a productive economic engine. It's because they've got us all to stare at a screen and then they sell all of our eyeballs to other people who want us to do business with them. It's not like terribly evil in my opinion, but it's just not going in the right place. That value comes from you. You should control where it goes. That is the endowment we already share. It just is going in the wrong place. And what Panvala is a movement to reclaim our endowment. It's a movement to dramatically increase the budgets of every single community on Earth. Not just crypto communities like DAOs, but definitely starting with them. Any DAO that you're in, we want to dramatically increase your budget. But also in the real world, your clubs, the nonprofits you support, your recreational sports league that you like to play with, your dance class or improv class, anytime you're coming together with the people you like to do the things you like, we want to dramatically increase the budget that you have to do those things using that endowment that we reclaim, that endowment that comes from your value that's going into somebody else's pockets. That's what we're all about. When our work is done, we'll have a community endowment for everybody to share. And you'll be able to decide where that goes. That endowment already exists. Our movement puts it in your control. So what are you gonna do with it? If you wanna preserve our climate for generations to come, our movement is gonna give you the resources to do that without winning an election. If you wanna make housing in our cities affordable to all kinds of people, our movement will give you the resources to make that happen. If you wanna provide a high quality education for the next generation without saddling them with crippling debt, right now that's a political effort. I believe it can be a community effort. And maybe you're not a do-gooder at all. Maybe there's not some grand cause, some grand vision of a better world that you want to live in. You just want to have a great time with the people you like. That's what our movement's about as well. We believe that endowment belongs to you, and you should be able to use it to do literally whatever you want with the community of people that you spend time with. That's what we're all about. So when it comes to reclaiming our endowment, the way we do that, the reason that I believe that crypto can actually change the world is because NFTs give us a new method of organizing people. These aren't the speculative NFTs that most people have heard about. These work a little bit differently. To give you what they are NFTs that fund your community when you collect them. The way you collect them is by making a purchase with the company that's offering them or completing a task that somebody wants to give you a stamp for doing. And then once you have that stamp, it has a face value on it that you can take to any community you want to fund doing the things you like with the people you like. That is how you reclaim this endowment. Collecting stamps is the vehicle for actually driving value back into the communities you care about. For a completely analog example, something involving no technology at all, something that just runs on cardboard, think about Box Tops for Education. If you've heard of this before, great. If you haven't, briefly, what it is a marketing program for General Mills cereals. What they want parents to do is when they go to the store and buy cereals, they want them to ignore all the other cereals on the shelf and just focus on the General Mills cereals and buy those. And what they say is that if you buy those cereals, keep the top of the box, take it to your kid's school, we will fund your school. That is a marketing expense for General Mills. They're saying we will fund your kid's school with our marketing budget if you buy our cereal. That is amazing, and that is literally how all marketing spending should work in our economy. That is what this movement is all about, by reclaiming all the advertising spending that's happening and driving it to your community the same way it works with cereals and cardboard. Instead of cardboard, we're gonna use NFTs. You're gonna go and collect as many NFTs, as many stamps as you can from businesses that are offering them. And instead of just schools being the beneficiaries of this funding, it's literally any community you want. It can be schools, that's great. It can be DAOs, that's where it's gonna start, but it can be literally any community you wanna support with your share of this endowment that belongs to you in the first place that we're gonna help you get back. So what these NFTs are, they're stamps that are purchased by advertisers. So again, they are taking their marketing budget and they're putting it in your control. They're spending money to give you the stamp. They're earned by customers. You go do business with them. You complete a task that they want you to do and you collect the stamp. Each of these stamps has a face value that says how much you're actually gonna get to fund your community with. And then you take it to the community you choose. I don't choose which community you fund. The company sponsoring it doesn't choose which community you fund. You get to take your share of our shared endowment that belongs to you to whichever community you want. So a brief illustration of how it works. If Coinbase wants to give you a $5 stamp to fund your community when you sign up for an account, that's pretty similar to what they already do. When you sign up for an account, a new person signing up for a Coinbase account, they will give you $5, it goes to you. What we're saying is we want to help companies give you $5 that goes to a community. So if Coinbase wants to do that, they put $5 in, let's say, a jar, the Panvala jar, they put $5 into it, they get the right to mint the stamp. The jar is a smart contract, but think of it as a jar. Once they mint the stamp, they can then offer it to their users. They can say, hey, if you sign up for an account, we're gonna give you this NFT, it's worth $5, take it to any community you want. We just want your business. We want you to do business with us rather than the companies that aren't actually funding your community. Once you collect that stamp, you then get to choose which community you wanna support. If I'm collecting the stamp, maybe I wanna take it to ATX DAO, a local city DAO here in Austin, Texas, and support the kind of events that they put on, like one happening later today. Go to atxdao.com/RSVP. You should definitely check out that event. But if I wanna support things like what ATX DAO does, I might take my stamp to them, you might take it somewhere else. But what taking the stamp to them does and redeeming it with them does is allows that community to withdraw the $5 that Coinbase put in the first place. Giving your community a stamp is what lets your community withdraw the funds that the sponsor put in. That's what these stamps are. It's pretty straightforward. What our collective action does through these stamps is shift value from middlemen like Facebook and Google into each and every one of our communities. Each time you collect one of these stamps, you're reclaiming that endowment that already belongs to you. It's your value that that advertising giants are collecting in their pockets. We want to help you take that back, and we want to help you solve the problems you care about, and help the communities you care about thrive by taking that value wherever you want it to go. So you can actually collect these stamps today. There's three stamps that exist right now at panvala.com/stamps. The first stamp you can collect is from Index Co-op. Some people from Index Co-op are speaking later today right here. What they did is they said, hey, we're gonna put some money in the endowment that communities can withdraw from, and then we now have 2,000 NFTs that we can give to people who sign up for their newsletter or who subscribe to their YouTube channel. That's the action they're trying to get people to do, and instead of buying ads for it and making Mark Zuckerberg richer so he can buy more of Hawaii, what they're doing with their marketing budget is giving it to you. They're helping you collect these NFTs, not out of charity, but because literally they want to achieve a business goal and they choose to fund your community to achieve that goal. Opolis is another company that's offering these stamps. Opolis is a decentralized employment benefits organization. If you work for a DAO, you're not getting health insurance, you're not getting tax forms. There's lots of stuff that you're not getting. When you're a member of Opolis and you work for a DAO, that's what Opolis does for you. If you refer somebody to Opolis, they give you a stamp. That's how they spend their marketing dollars. they give it to you to fund any community you want. So definitely go to panvala.com/stamps, collect stamps. If your community is not currently receiving these stamps, we want to plug your community into the network so any community you care about can benefit from this model. This is a network for all communities, any DAO out there, any non-DAO, any real-world organization, community. It's literally for anybody you would want to take your funds to be able to use those in that way. And lastly, if you're a company that wants to be able to market in a Web3 native way, again, rather than buying ads, giving money to some middleman, when eliminating middlemen is what Web3 is all about, what you can do is sponsor stamps. And again, like these companies have done, you can give out stamp NFTs to your customers to be able to spend in any community they want when they drive more value to your business, not at a charity, but as a return on investment for your business. So send us an email at stamps@panvala.com and let's get started on a campaign for you. That's Panvala. We're gonna shift all the money that's going to middlemen today to go into your communities, and that's how crypto is gonna change the world. Thanks, everybody.